Why Windows Backup isn't what you think it is. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Now, if you've been following me or reading my stuff for any length of time, you'll know that I talk about backing up a lot. I think it's really important, and I keep referring to it as basically the nearest thing to a silver bullet that can help you recover from just about anything. So when I heard that Microsoft was adding something called Windows Backup some months ago, got my hopes up. My thought was that they were finally replacing or updating Backup and Restore Windows 7. I was sorely disappointed. Let's have a look at what it is here in Windows 11. So all I'm going to do is click on the Start button and search for Windows Backup. And there it is. You can see it's got the greenish cloud icon with an upward pointing arrow. One of the things to realize about this particular program is that it is consistent with Microsoft's confusing and misleading naming scheme. Most specifically, Windows Backup does not back up Windows. It's kind of like System Restore doesn't restore your system. The old Backup and Restore Windows 7 creates a full system image backup, thus backing up everything, Windows and everything else on your machine. Windows Backup, this new feature, isn't related to that at all. It's very selective about what it does back up and how it backs it up. The first item here in Windows Backup says folders. Backup files from desktop, documents, pictures, folders to OneDrive. This should sound really familiar. This is nothing more than the horrible, and in my opinion, even dangerous, OneDrive backup feature. Now, in one sense, okay, this is good. Documents you're working on, for example, that are in the documents folder will be uploaded automatically to OneDrive online. If your machine dies, then your documents will still be there. However, there are issues. OneDrive is not backup. It's synchronization. If a document is added or changed anywhere else signed into the same OneDrive account, it'll be downloaded to your machine's OneDrive in place of overwriting the current copy. You'll merge the desktops of multiple machines. This one has recently confused a lot of people, and it's very frustrating. If you have more than one machine signed into the same OneDrive account, and this backup is turned on, then the desktop of each machine will be backed up to a single desktop folder at OneDrive.com. That will then dutifully be synchronized with all of the desktops on all of the machines. The result is that if you have something on your desktop on one machine, it'll be replicated to the desktops of all the machines, effectively merging the contents of all the desktops into a single desktop. And of course, you may very quickly hit your OneDrive storage limit. This may prevent you from even sending or receiving email in your associated Microsoft email account. In the worst case, it's possible that if ignored long enough, files could be removed to make space. The only solutions to this problem are to either remove attachments from your stored email, since those count, remove files from OneDrive, or purchase more OneDrive space. You can guess which one Microsoft would probably prefer you do. It's a mess. I recommend you avoid by never turning on this feature. Now, there are some other backed up items, and you can see those here on the screen. There's apps, remember installed apps and pinned app preferences, settings, remember Windows settings and preferences, credentials, remember accounts, Wi-Fi networks, and other passwords. These are not unreasonable things to have backed up, but they're not critical. They can make setting up a machine much smoother if you expect to reuse the same apps and settings and credentials. But at best, they are a convenience, not a backup. Now, Of course, it gets a little more confusing. You can see that we've run the Windows Backup app here. It displays some of the settings we care about, but it really only just seems to be designed for setting it up in the first place. If you want to make changes later, then the better place to go, as it turns out, is, of course, the Windows Settings app. So I'm going to right-click on the Start button, click on Settings, and then in Accounts of all places, scroll down if need be to find Windows Backup. And there it is. The OneDrive folder syncing that we've talked about. Well, that is in fact just OneDrive. And if I click on the Setup Syncing button, it will actually open up the OneDrive Backup feature configuration dialog box. Remember my apps, remember my preferences, etc. If we actually expand Remember My Preferences, because of this little down arrow here, you can see you can choose which ones you want to have synchronized across the machines. Again, this is slightly more granularity than the original Windows Backup interface, but this is where you can make the changes or even turn off various features. Now, as it turns out, we've got two places so far. Windows Backup will actually show up in a few other places at times. Because I've been using this machine for a while already, it's not happening here. But if you don't have Windows Backup turned on, you may find a scary message in the Settings app. Action advised, backup your PC. It's the exact same feature. If you click continue on that, you'll end up on the Windows Backup Settings page. I do not recommend you do this. The action Windows advises is not the action you should take for all of the reasons I've discussed above. So what should you do? Well, it's not that difficult. Instead of using Windows Backup, instead of using the OneDrive Backup feature, do this. Use OneDrive as a great place to keep your documents. Create folders within the OneDrive folder and organize and place your work there as you see fit. These files will be synchronized to OneDrive.com and any other machines signed into the same OneDrive/Microsoft account. Don't mess with, don't use, don't rely on the default documents folder. Microsoft sticks its fingers in there at times in ways that you really don't want it to. It's much cleaner if you simply focus on your own folders of your own creation in your own locations. And of course, back up your entire machine for real. My recommendation is to use a tool like Macrium Reflect or Easus To Do or many others to create a periodic full image backup of your machine. This will back up Windows and everything else. Now, Windows Backup is, perhaps, better than no backup at all, but the side effects and the shortcomings are just too serious to ignore. The one thing Microsoft and I agree on is that backing up is important, but it's also important to do it right so that the things you think are backed up are truly backed up and in a way that you can get at them. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/174779. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.